Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
Well, yesterday was certainly kind of a cold and blustery day. Today, not so much. Temperatures were above average, but with the dry air and the calm winds and the mostly clear skies, it's going to cool off pretty quickly this evening. Temperatures will be falling into the 40s in News 8 Storm Team Forecast. Mostly clear, just some thin high-level clouds overnight, but cold. Lows will be 28 to around 34, so a lot of us will get down to freezing. Then partly sunny for tomorrow. The clouds are going to filter the sunshine on and off all day, but another mild one with highs getting up to 58 to around 62. Winds will be out of the southwest at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. On the almanac today, again, yesterday's high, by the way, was only 46. It was well below average. Today, we almost got up to near 60 degrees. The average for this time of the year is 55. The record, we weren't close to that at all. 73 set back in 1964. And another day without rainfall. Can you believe it? 43 now in Sealands Grove. That's a cool spot. Down to 46 in Lebanon. Still 53 in Lancaster. York's coming in around 52, 56 in Chambersburg and in Lewistown. So numbers are cooling down at different rates in different locations. Just a few thin clouds right now. Officially at Harrisburg International Airport, 53 degrees. No wind chill at these temperatures. At least officially, the formula doesn't compute them. The relative humidity is 48%. Winds are to the south around 10 miles per hour. Pressure's not all that high, just over 30 inches. Regional satellite and the radar showing the system that brought us the brisk conditions yesterday now moving away. High pressure is building in and actually already starting to move away from us. Now, the good thing about that in one aspect is it gets us back in the southwesterly flow for tomorrow, so that brings us some more mild temperatures. So satellite picking up a lot of very high, thin clouds. They show up as bright white on the infrared satellite because they're just so cold. They'll be moving pretty quickly in the westerly flow, warm front going off to the north. So even though we'll see more cloud cover tomorrow than we did today, we have other things working for us to get us some milder temperatures. Those thin clouds start moving through overnight tonight in our predictor computer model, and they go through in batches, waves almost, for the next couple of days. The front that was barely on that particular map gets a little closer as we head towards Monday. Starts slowing down a little bit, so we'll have increasing clouds on Monday. Just a chance of some showers arriving by the end of the day. And then a couple of waves of low pressure will ride that boundary, slow it down. And depending on exactly where it meanders, north or south, the beginning of the new work week could have an effect on temperatures. But it looks like most of the rain holds off to Monday night into Tuesday. The front doesn't completely clear the area until the middle part of the week, and then we start to bring in some cooler temperatures again. So up near 60 again for tomorrow. Partly sunny skies. Showers arrive during the day on Monday. Doesn't look like a washout yet, but periods of rain and drizzle on Tuesday. Should be a mild day, but then temperatures start dropping behind the front on Wednesday, and more brisk, blustery conditions for the end of the work week. A little bit of a weather seesaw going on here right now, Jim.
A nice weekend.
Yeah, it was a pretty nice day.
All right. Thanks, Matt.